All right, well, hello everybody. It's Matthew, your friendly neighborhood technician, making another video for you out of Boise on this extremely cold day. It's about 16 degrees out, and if you can see, this is just the aftermath of the past week of weather we've had, the snowstorms. And this is why I can't get out to do any work. So I have made advanced further on the Corvette there. It has turned into a full electrical diagnosis, and I am chasing shorts. It looks like I may need to be replacing a junction box and also a ignition switch, but that'll be a different video. Today, I want to make a video for you. I've worked on this particular job. This is going to be, I believe, an 08, just to be exactly sure. Let me see here. Yep, well, it's an 09 actually. This is gonna be an 08-09 Chevy Silverado, GMC 1500, you name it. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be pulling the instrument panel on the dashboard here. We're gonna be pulling all the instruments on it. Now, it's probably working. No, it is not. See. No, it's not working. Okay, so the instrument panel right now is not working. And so that's what happens. The complaint is that the instrument panel will intermittently work. Sometimes you'll get in your truck and it'll work, sometimes it won't. Now, this is for the 2007 all the way on up to 2014-15 Chevy GMC 1500 Silverados. The procedure is pretty much going to be the same all the way across the board. The only differences that I've ran into on the procedure is some vehicles have fasteners, which is just plastic clips, and all this is just clipped in. Some of them have screws, some of them have Torx bits. Some of them you can, you know, pull this apart, pop it right off. Some of them you have to reach down in here and look for hidden screws and other things like that. And so we're gonna get started on this. I hope I've got good camera angles for you. I'm gonna keep the camera on my head for this one and just post it regardless of how it turns out. So the first thing you're gonna wanna have, what I'm gonna do is stick this key in here. And just for, I don't know, I've worked in a shop for 10 years. So I'm just gonna open the hood, take a peek, and go from there. Put my key in my door. Alrighty then. Now, a couple of ratchets. It's good to have some pry bars and whatnot. You really don't want to use screwdrivers to pry some of this stuff off, because mainly because you'll end up scratching and scuffing your dashboard up. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is make a spot here. So the first thing I've done is I've pulled the fuse panel off. Okay. And now this is also going to be an option for you. You don't necessarily have to remove the bottom kick panel if you don't want to. It will just pop and you'll have access to what you need to get to inside of here. Okay, which are gonna be some bolts and stuff. So yeah, if you don't want to remove, see if you can see that there, your screws there, just be a little gentle with it and pop that off there, and you should be all right to go. You should be good to go. And then here should just pop off. Again, be gentle. Alright, and then once you get it off, you're just gonna have to be patient with it. Twist it so you can get into these plugs here. And this is where working with gloves becomes not so much fun. And just get your plug and there you go. So now you've got that off there. Okay. Let's see here. You're also gonna wanna adjust your steering wheel. See, next piece you're gonna wanna try to get off is going to be this cover piece. And again, it just pops off. Be gentle with it. Let me get you in here, see if you can see what I'm doing. There you go. And you just press that down and you just pull that right on out of there. And then you can go ahead and set this aside somewhere safe. It's cold, it's plastic, and so it's going to be brittle. So just be careful. Alrighty then. Now that we've got good access here, the next step that we're going to want to take, we've got a couple of Torx bits that are going to be up inside of here and here. And some of them will not have this Torx bit up inside of here, okay? Let's go ahead and get that off, and I actually believe that to be a T15 or a T10, which I thought, let's see. I believe that was a T15 that I just had there. Yes, they're going to be a T10. And actually, I'm just able to use my fingers here. And again, I hate working with gloves because I can't feel anything. There you go, find a safe spot for that little screw. See if you can see up inside of there. Okay, and again, just a reminder, you may not have two of these screws there, you may just have a clip. And so just, you know, kind of see for yourself what you got going on. Okay, let's see if we can get... And there you go. That piece will just come up and out. And now you've got two back here as well. So we're gonna need to get this piece removed, and then we're gonna start using our 8mm at this point. And actually on this, set. We're good. We actually did not need to move this out of the way, so we'll just get that set back straight when the time comes. No worries there. Alrighty then. Let's go ahead and start getting this piece off. And what this is gonna do is this is gonna remove the cover right here, because that's all this is a plastic cover. And then back here will be our instrument panel. So, and I believe that is going to be an 8mm. Oh no, that's gonna actually be a 7. That is gonna be a 7. And again, it's not, you know, this stuff isn't put in with a lot of torque. So you should be able just to take it apart by hand. Okay, now you set that aside there, and now you've got access to one, it's gonna be down under here, two, and then three, and then four. So let's get to work. I got something in my eye, a little piece of dust or lint or something. And notice as I'm messing with this, it's actually acting up. And so the next video that I make is going to show how I look these over and find cracked or bad solder points or shorts. Sometimes I cannot repair them. Sometimes I cannot fix the solder and I just need to replace them. Boy, it's cold. My hands are cold. That's okay though. I got four babies to feed, so I don't mind the cold. All right. Now we can just pull this out of here. Okay, and you're gonna wanna kinda turn it and twist it, because you've got a plug in back here. And now we're going to start our diagnosis, because it all starts at this plug-in. And there you go, folks. Instrument panel has now been removed. Okay, what we're going to want to do, We're gonna wanna open this up. So I've got the special bits needed to get in here, pull this apart. I wanna check the solder connections inside of here and see where that goes. So I will go inside where it is nice and warm and get warmed up and go from there. So I kinda need some like closing theme music, huh? Da, na, 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 na. This is it, folks. It's time to sign off. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching my videos. Thanks for supporting me. Matthew, your friendly neighborhood technician. If you have any questions or comments, please shoot me an email. I'd be happy to walk you through any of these procedures or anything that you need in greater detail. Alrighty then. Well, once again, this is Matthew, your friendly neighborhood technician, signing off.